So Global Goddess with Golden Look Dawn here, a September 4 by Global View out of a Jet Danza by Jet Master. The Dam was a grade 3 winner. That's Jet Danza. Stamina speed I've got written down here, and stats are, the stats good. There is some inbreeding to three champions there. And same with Dame Colleen previous, there is a lot of champion inbreeding, and the percentages are 86% with the Knicks, and nicking with the Dam to the you know, the Dam with the sire. And the Dam broodmare, the 79% and 86%. So there's good stats there for the you know, mixing up all the pedigrees and their foals going on the train, and they end up winning. Number 4 is High Hosanna, and that is by Trippy. That speed there, Trippy was a fast individual up to a mile. The Dam was Biblical Susan by Bernardini Australia, USA dirt horse and turf. Biblical Susan was an Australian Australian filly. Now what have I got for Biblical Susan? Biblical Susan had 8 starts and she was a winner. The second Dam, Sharp Susan, had 22 starts and won a group 2. And multiple inbred 5 times with champions. And the 63% Nick's, nicking stats for mares. Dam the sire, 44.9% first time out. Broodmare the sire, 54% first time out, and all of the family, 63% of the starters, either win or, you know, get placed. So that is a good horse on debut with that pedigree. Now number 5 is Jewel of Doha, and we've already mentioned that. Jewel of Doha, there's coming a bit money for it to improve, but I think it's a bit of a staying family. Jewel of Doha is an August foal. The Dam was a listed winner, and it's another South African, good South African family. Rio Supreme by Kokari. That's another one of the cotton horses that was just in front of Jewel of Doha last time. And there's like nothing but choose between those two. Last time there was like a head between Rio Supreme and Jewel of Doha, who were 2 lengths behind Winter Mosaic and Quintus Light, who all meet up in this race today. So there could be a little bit, they could, you could see Jewel of Doha or Rio Supreme coming late if it's a really fast race, because they have got stamina in the Dam sides and in the stallions. So I would say there's more stamina in the cotton horses. Both of the cotton horses have got stamina. So maybe they are for another day, but you can't put it past, if it is a really fast race, they will come through late. Seeking Peace, Mike Stewart, his horse has run twice. It's the first time he was down the field. Come second, come last, but then he second run he had improved just behind Winter Mosaic, and which tends me to think that this form isn't that strong for this Winter Mosaic, even though it won in Justin Snate as a trainer. I think Dame Colleen and High Hosanna are the ones, and Global Goddess are the ones to concentrate on here. Treasure Hunt is number 8. Here's another one. The Dam had 19 starts and was a winner. But there's a lot of stamina in that family, so we'll just leave that out. We buy, you know, the sire, Elusive Ford and Silvano, the Dam sire. There's a lot of stamina there, so we'll just leave that. But I say the winner, the Dam had 19 starts and was a winner, and the second Dam was a Group 3 winner in the family, so it's another decent, you know, South African Dam, but a German Dam sire. And Elusive Fort, obviously, American USA horse, but the breeding, but was running in South Africa, so Elusive Fort is basically a South African stallion now. by Fort Wood, actually.
If I remember,
he's a son of Fort Wood. So, what we're going to do is now, I've looked through the pedigrees, and I think High Hosanna, which is 63-20 in the betting, Dame Colleen, which is 10-1 in the betting, and Global Goddess, them three newcomers could be a bit. A couple above these ones that's already had a run. Looking at their pedigrees look a bit better. Because I, even though I looked through the form of Winter Mosaic, I did go through the pedigrees. And the pedigrees are decent. But I think the pedigree of High Hosanna and Dame Colleen are a standout. And they're both owned by the same owners. You know, Dragonstein Stud. So there's actually... you know, Mr. Rupert, he's got 1, 2, 3, he's got 4 in this race, and he likes to have winners at this meeting. And their setup is based in the Cape Town, beautiful place, just below the mountains. But anyway, I think this race could go to High Hosanna. I worked it out that High Hosanna has probably got the best pedigree. But I was, you know, in the breeding stats and the, you know, everything else. But when I looked at Dame Colleen, they were quite similar to in the stats for winning, you know, with the pedigree. So, and that one is 10-1. So I wouldn't put it past that Dame Colleen to come out and win this. I know Justin Snaith, this is his race. He normally wins this race, but... You know, Candy's Bass has been training a lot better this year. Her horses, they went off a bit. They started well. They went off a bit. Now they're coming back. But I think this Dame Colleen or Global Goddess even could be the one. But I would rather say Dame Colleen could be the one if it's not High Hosanna, because, you know, that's a Dragonstein. They do like having this winner. So I'm thinking that would one of them too. Is ready, and I think that the other Dragonstein, Rio Supreme, is more of a stayer, more of a miler. But you never know if it's a fast pace. He's obviously put it in there. If there's a fast pace, you know, the Dragonstein, and if there is a fast pace, that brings Rio Supremo and Joel of Doha in, you know. But it depends. But I think this Dame Colleen and High Hosanna, that's 2 and 4, could be the 1 and 2 in this race. So we'll go 1 and 2, Dame Colleen at 10-1, and 4 High Hosanna. And that's the tip. We'll do the quartet for you. I'll go for Winter Mosaic for 3rd, and then I'll go for Jewel of Doha for 4th. So that's 2, 4, 1, 5 for the quartet.
Two, 4, 1, 5, 11, 10 quartet. What I'll do is I'll go through every race today. I was just testing my recording equipment out and thought I'd do it that way first, just to see how it turned out. Because it's going on, it's already sent out on the podcast, Flat Racing Guru on